Now, just like I promised on my Instagram, if that comment right there got over 300 likes, I would make a video on ZillaKami, and here we are, so let's talk about it. This is a rapper a lot of people have asked me to talk about. It seems like the majority of people who come across his stuff at least have some kind of appreciation for his music, but why is that? What is it really about him? I think when it comes to ZillaKami, one of the main reasons as to why he's prospering in the first place is simply because he's one of the best rappers in his particular space doing what he does. Obviously, I'm talking about the whole trap metal scene. In the past, I've talked about someone like Scarlord, who's also one of the main rappers winning with this particular style. When it comes to ZillaKami though, one of his appeals is the fact that his entire sound is very rough. I think considering the lane he's in, it does make sense that it is like this, because you don't listen to one of his tracks expecting to hear something that's smooth. This is a person who has a track record of being chaotic in everything you hear from him. ZillaKami knows how to make something sound very messy but somehow still good. I think this has to do with the fact that his entire sound is, just raw on a whole nother level. But at the same time, strangely enough, it's also controlled. He just has a way of containing the madness and the craziness that goes on in his records. It seems like he's found the perfect blend of rap and metal. ZillaKami to me is really just spicing up and diversifying the options there is in hip hop. On one hand, not everyone wants to listen to a Lil Pump, and then on the other hand, not everyone wants to listen to a J. Cole. And then here we have ZillaKami, who's completely different from any of those guys. But then again, he's interesting enough to the point where you want to hear a little bit more from him. One thing I've noticed about him though is, despite being a very energetic, raw, and chaotic kind of rapper, he's actually very predictable. In the sense that he's found the perfect formula that works for him. Of course, this can be good, but then again, the bad thing about this is most of the time, it kind of gets repetitive. I don't personally think I could listen to ZillaKami all day, every day, like I can with some other artists, just because I don't think, at least for now, he's not that versatile. Even though I can count on him to give me the exact thing I became a fan of him for, I do think bringing different parts of his artistry to the surface would be very beneficial for him. And really, the good thing about him being in this place is there's a lot of room for improvement. That's the biggest upside here. When it comes to him overall as a rapper, one thing I want to say is, of course, he's an acquired taste. Not everyone is gonna be a fan of him, and to be honest, I think most people are actually gonna not like him, because at first listen, he might actually be quote-unquote too much for some people, especially if you aren't used to listening to this kind of music. But the question still stands, ZillaKami, is he good? Yes, he definitely is. Just like I said earlier, there's a lot of room for improvement when it comes to Zilla. I think once we get the chance to see him exploring other parts of himself as a rapper on his future music, that's when things are gonna get really interesting for him. So yeah, just like I promised, here's a video on ZillaKami. If there's any other video suggestions, any other rappers you want me to talk about, hit me up on my Instagram. I'm gonna put it on the screen right now. Now, what do you personally think about ZillaKami though? Is this maybe the first time you're hearing about him, or have you been on him for some time now? Definitely let me know in the comment section below, and let's have a discussion about this.